to No But For Real, where we give you the keys to success,
bueno,
fulfillment, and empowerment.
And bueno.
Happiness. And bueno. All right, so we're going to start with a topic today that's going to lead into a few more episodes, but I'm just going to throw it to you right away. What does it mean to be a man in today's world?
Don't give it to him.
What do you... Come back.
So what...
Okay, see?
So
I told you.
Well, good, Doug, but be thinking, like, to what does it really be... A man, what does that really mean to someone if you're trying to teach or embody that to a teenager?
That is a throw at you.
Does it, don't you think it matters who the audience is? Like, who are you talking to? Are you talking to?
I don't think it matters.
You don't think it matters?
Nope.
Yeah, I don't think it matters either.
But there's so many facets to that question.
I think there's a, well.
What does it mean to be a father? What does it mean to be a husband? What does it mean to be?
Yeah. Those are
true
specifics, though. What's it mean to be a man?
But those are part of being a man.
Okay, so let's start then with...
How do I not write a 1,000-page essay on this?
What do you think most teenage boys in American culture today, what's their view of what a man should be? Let's start
there.
What
a man should be.
Yeah, what do you think
in
their mind?
What a mighty good man.
Name the artist.
It's
Salt and Pepper.
Salt and
Pepper. Yeah.
Okay.
I think... I know when I was growing up, and I grew up with... Like all women, basically, because my mom was there, my grandma was there, basically for most of it, and they always imparted to me that a man is someone that takes care of their family, and that was like the number one
provider.
Thing. Yep, no matter what you do, and that doesn't mean that I'm the head honcho. Like that was never because my mom was the head honcho, but it was whatever you do, you just. Like the number one role for a man is to take care of their family, whether that's like family, like my kids and my wife, or taking care of my mom and like that family. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
It was always to like put that above all else.
Interesting.
What do you think?
And that might be cultural, though.
I mean, I could say like him. Like I think, like with most things in my life, thank God, my thoughts on that have changed over the years,
right.
And I think where I'm at right now and where our society's at, I really try not even think about what's the difference besides,
it's what do you
becoming
mean,
more
difference?
Blurry, isn't it?
What's the difference between like a male and a female and what role should we have?
Play.
Like what's the point of even having roles? Because, it's hard to say because, like you said, it is still very ingrained in our culture. Like, a man takes care of his family. And I agree. They do. But so does a woman. Like,
yeah,
they
for
should.
Sure.
You know what I mean? Like, it should be, especially if you're entering into a marriage, it should be an equal part of taking care of things. Like, like around my house, for instance, and this wasn't right away because of how I grew up. Like, there was a day my wife just walked in and she's like, I'm done with your laundry. And I was like, what do you mean? And she's like, no, I'm done doing it. She's like, you can do your laundry. Now, part of that's because I screw it up. But it was also just like, I do enough laundry, like, you can do your own. And, and I like to cook, but I cook a lot of the time. I clean the house more than she does.
For sure. I think,
so.
I don't know if the, like, maybe if you were to ask that question and this was 1950. I think
it'd
maybe
be totally different.
I think what we would say would be the same, but the action that
would be like this.
Right. The action while we're smoking our pipe.
Yes, yes.
Drinking our scotch.
Well, her job is to have cookies and milk for Beaver when she gets home.
In sociology, we have a whole unit on gender roles, and we look back at some of the commercials that used to be out there on TV or the original TV shows. I mean, it's
amazing.
It's
for
funny, but it's
yes.
almost appalling. Like, you feel bad watching it with
that's
girls in there because it was like, I didn't make him the right cup of coffee.
I know, it was, I know.
Like, what am I going to do?
This coffee's a little weak, honey.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
But I think if...
My wife would be like, go get your own coffee.
Our response to that question would be the same, but like the actions that would identify what is taking care of your family would be different. Like a man would be like, I work and I provide monies.
Yeah.
But now, I'm still taking care of my family, but like I'm... helping change diapers,
dishes.
My wife helps take care of the family by going out and making money.
Right.
So I think it's just like the actions are different and what it looks like is different, but the overall goal, I guess, of a man is the same.
True. And you guys are bringing up points that are going to kind of come up in a future episode. So why I bring this up is I'm in the middle of a book right now. It's called Mask of Masculinity by Lewis House. And what it does is it takes –
like, I don't know why that name
eight
is
to ten topics about what we think it means to be a man or to be a male in our society.
Yeah.
And when he started talking about this on his podcast, it's called School of Greatness, it made sense to me, and why I wanted to read it is because if you look at our world today and like the major problems that we have, it's all started by men
let me get them out.
Who are in power positions, mostly.
Testosterone, man. It's a powerful hormone.
Right.
So it is a powerful hormone.
When I see all these things, and I don't want to start a political debate on the show or anything like that, but I think we have to start teaching like young males and teenage boys what it really means to be a man. And I think you're right. I was, and I'm not going to pretend I was perfect by any means. I cringe at some of the things of the culture and you know, what we thought or what we thought was cool or what we said when we were growing up in high school, and we know what goes on today. But it was like for our generation, it was like, you know, Stifler and guys like that were cool from American Pie.
Wait a second, from whose generation?
Well, I mean, you're older. But even if we think about
it, I think it was like 24 when I saw that.
Right. Well, reality TV or the people that are popular are now on social media is like the things that are celebrated and the things that even they see from athletes sometimes of saying like, this is a man or this is how I act. It's like, when they get to, it's hard to say, because if I would hear this message when I'm younger, I would just roll my eyes, like, whatever.
You know, I'm sorry, this isn't like exactly on it, but it just hit me because you wanted, you know, to kind of think like, you know, how should young males, you know, kind of approach this right now?
What should they aspire to be?
Well, you know, and it's funny because here's something that probably will never go away, honestly. But as not everybody gets older, but definitely as I got older, it's just ridiculous. And I just tell the kids it is. Like, the idea of, you know, teenagers like, oh, I want to fight you for basically no reason whatsoever, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm always just like, but then you do, right? And here's what you don't realize. Number one, you look like complete idiots.
Yeah.
Because you watched one too many movies. So as you line up like you're a boxer and you end up just slapping each other a little bit, like, great.
Right.
I thank God somebody's recording this, because you should watch it.
That's one of the masks that we're going to talk about is people do that because they feel like if I don't do that, then my man card's taken.
Well, but here's the thing.
I can't defend myself.
I that just makes me laugh. But the true thing is, like, because it's hard, I guess, to wrap your head around when you're a kid. And it really is true, is like, what exactly are you proving? Like, how is this doing anything that's going to even, like...
It's constructive.
Well, right. Okay, so somebody insulted you, like... So if you do beat them up...
What does that show? That you are so butthurt that that's...
that you're such a baby that you can't take... You can't take somebody and make fun of you?
Calling you a name.
Exactly. That's the way I think about it. It's like oh, you're such a baby that you have to throw fists because somebody said something to you?
That's
my favorite phrase.
Yeah, talk about that, because that is at the heart of, I think, this issue in the book and the topics that we're going to talk about coming up is that phrase... Man up, and that is like the umbrella statement that all this garbage goes to. So
I think when people say that, it brings up, it's supposed to bring out, like, you know, everything that, you know, I like what Doug was talking about, like that aggressive nature, like, you know, man up, you know, go in there and punch that dude in the face. Don't let him talk to you. Don't let him talk that way about you.
Right.
Don't let him talk about your girl like that. Go to him, fight him.
Yeah.
Or man up, like, don't let that guy affect you. Like, that's what it really should be.
Hey, let's be honest, and I know, you know, it's hard to, and again, I know all this is hard for a young person to do. How about man up and just go up to someone and be like, hey, dude, don't do that.
Yeah.
I don't appreciate that. My girlfriend doesn't appreciate it. And yes, most likely, because they're probably a jerk already, they'll probably keep doing it. And that's when you just go, listen, I'm just going to tell you right now, like, you can keep going if you want, but it doesn't really affect
me. I think it's weak-minded when people resort to violence, especially when I see young men do it, and it's just like, man,
that's the thing, is when we look at the culture, there's a lack of positive male role models.
For sure.
And you can point to that just within the American family today as it currently stands. Like, no, but for real, like, being a good husband and being a good father...
It's not popular.
Here's the thing, though. Sometimes that I wouldn't say it annoys me, because I think it's great when it happens, but when it's celebrated to the umpteenth degree that someone did what they're supposed to do, because it's like, oh my God, a guy actually did what he's supposed to do. I'm like, okay, that's great that he did
it. A guy paid child support. It's like, all right.
Well, it's not that.
Isn't that a law?
Like, he went to his child's game.
Oh, I see.
Or he helped them with homework.
Yeah.
Or he made dinner. Or he cleaned the house. I do that every day. And I don't say that to, like, you know,
I don't put
myself
on Instagram.
On
right. Like, look what I did today.
Yeah.
Oh, well, maybe that's part of the issue.
So that's stop. You know? Like, I think you guys will really like it when we go through these topics. We'll lay the outline down and cool. for them. But I think my no, but for real, and we'll get this wrapped up, is because there's so much we can go into, is we need to change the dialogue in our country about what masculinity is and what it means to be a man. And if we start doing that and allow young males to be more vulnerable and express themselves, mm-hmm. we're not going to have so much tension and so much of right versus wrong, and you're wrong because you're different, and then I got to man up and prove I'm right. Yeah. So it just snowballs from there. So that's my no, but for real.
No, but for real, and I'm going to – and I'll try to continue with this theme of man up and, like, what does it really mean?
To man up?
Yeah, to man up. Like, I don't think – like, when I say it, when I think of it, I think it's different than what people may have, like, originally thought that what that phrase means. And, you know, I just want to talk about that more. Like, that's something I want to explore.
It's going to be a good one.
I would say two things. One would be man up, maybe is a phrase we should just get rid of and be like, that sounds
person up.
Person up. Human I mean,
up.
Like, you know.
Or do the right thing.
Yeah, that would be number one. And number two, which I'm sure we'll get into at some point, going back to this issue of, like, being a man means you're tough. Well, hey, guess what? You can still be tough and, like, be vulnerable. You can still be a soldier who runs in, you know, to a battlefield and is, like, you know, doing all this stuff, but also still, like, watch a movie and cry throughout the whole thing. Like, it's you don't have to have one and not the other. Like, it could be both. It's okay. In fact, you can still be super tough guy if you actually are and walk away from a fight.
Yeah,
you know,
that might be
because if you really
tough.
And it is because if you really know it to yourself, like, I don't know, I could probably take this guy, but you're just like, not worth it.
Toughness is being able to do the thing that you're afraid to do, and then being okay doing it. So I think there's a ton of great stuff that we're gonna have coming up. Audience, especially women, tell us,
women.
Like from
the women's. All the women.
From a female perspective, what is the thing that drives you nuts, or what is the thing that you wish more people, especially males, would identify being manly?
Is there a character limit on this?
140, just like a tweet. You can't send anything more than a tweet. All right. And then on the flip side of that is the guys out there, tell us something that you've done that you felt pressured to do because you had to live up to that man up.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that is because it's real, that pressure that's out there, and then we can talk about how to get through that. So, great stuff coming up.
Oh, and man up.
Your punch is like the dude from Wedding Singer. You see that movie?
Yeah,
like,
I was just dancing.
I'm gonna get you.
Hey, let me man up.
You know that scene?
No, but that just, I was just like, oh, is that really what it looks like?
Let's get a slow-mo of that. Doug's punch in real life.
That's actually actually full speed.
No, dude, you gotta.
He winds up like he's gonna punch the dude's, and it's just like he's like, what?
It's a movie punch. You can't really punch somebody.
It's Blue. From old school, but
I haven't seen that in a long time.